Hi, my name is Colin Faver, and I'm doing this week's mix for Hypnosis.
Benvenuti a Belfast, io sono Stefano.
E sono Pablo.
E siamo delle Underground Promotion.
Welcome to Belfast, that was Stefano, Pablo, and I'm Cliff McKay.
Underground began about 2 years ago when a lot of the illegal raves were getting clamped down. So Underground decided to go illegal.
I would say that the Belfast scene is not as professional as the Italian scene, but much better.
It may be quiet on the surface, but underneath it all, the Irish are well known for wanting to party and enjoy themselves.
We're in Belfast here, and we're headed off for Hall. We're going to get into Hellraiser on a tour of 5, and we're going to go bonkers right through to 5 o'clock.
Hellraiser is just totally an elite party thing. It's the only way to experience.
When the planet wants from the planet funk.
It's entertainment. That's the most important thing.
Hi, I'm one of the dancers at the Rolling. Good band from Northern Ireland. There are two dancers down here with the band. That's techno band going over here. Check it.
I come here, this is just brilliant. And the Hellraiser and the Ulster Hall, Belfast, and it's just unreal. Brilliant. Pablo and Egypt Groove, just the best you've ever seen. Brilliant.
I want also make people happy, you know, like to little show when I play.
Well, I think the dance scene over here is just taking a bit of a time to sort of develop. Obviously, heavy metal over here is very big. So, I mean, the young kids coming up, an alternative to heavy metal is that hardcore thump, thump, thump. Thump, thump, thump. I'm involved with Skippy Records, also managed band Erotics, Inner Motions, Bennett John.
I'm hidden identity, I'm a hip-hop rapper, and I'm a rave artist. People are sick of hearing politicians force views and issues down throats that people don't understand or don't want to hear. I'm not going to do that anymore. I want people to decide for themselves what's right and what's wrong, because in the end of the day, they're the only people that can do that. The rave scene over here is something that a lot of people are into. I MC at it, even though I'm a hardcore hip-hop rapper. But that is the only place that I can get my message across to.
Too close yet, too far, too near, not too clear. Could you fill my mind, supposed to flake me with fear? With eyes and side cross, with tears, with no tear. But flash lit the flame, but who is to blame? The one who blows and the one who brings wood. The man is a sin, if he does bad for good. The edge is provoked, then you choke on the smoke. Cause you've learned that if you play with fire, you get burned.
I don't really want to get into that. I do return to Belfast to DJ. I've played at Sugarsweet a couple of occasions and other clubs in Belfast. Clubs are not segregated by religion at all. Catholics and Protestants mix openly. There's nothing like that going on in any of the clubs in Belfast. I mean, there is the tension there, of course, which they're living with, but in general, every time I go home, I'm amazed by how enthusiastic everyone is, you know. It's still a very, very vibrant scene there, and you can't knock it, you know. It's only recently that it's coming together, that kids are going out together, having a good time, and a lot of boundaries have been broken down through the music and through the whole scene.
The situation in Belfast doesn't really affect the next out. You know, everybody just knocks out, have a good time. All the partnerships are Catholic and Protestant, so it doesn't make a difference, it doesn't affect us in any way.
Certainly the legal forces over here are paranoid of people having fun. They always tend to, you know, seem like the killjoys, when let's face it, at the end of the day, there's never any trouble at any dance event, or very little trouble, and it's a waste of their time really to be there. I mean, at the end of the day, everybody's there to have a good time. Sugarsweet crowd are just so open-minded that they'll give any DJ, a guest DJ, a good reception if he plays well. And I think once the DJ comes overseas with the crowds like, they respond as well, because there hasn't been a bad night at Sugarsweet. Basically what Sugarsweet's all about, we've just been sort of moving on and just doing different things, just keeping it fresh. The crowd are just basically going apeshit, you know, they just love it really. They're not interested in sort of like the troubles or like sort of hanging around street corners.
Sugarsweet, man, living excellent, right? No paramilitary shit here.
What you're actually getting in Belfast is quality over quantity.
David and I started working together like 4 years ago, and from that, Sugarsweet came about. I enjoy playing because you're playing to your friends. You're playing to people that you've known, that you've got to know over the years.
All the people in Northern Ireland come together. They think there's lots of trouble, but really, really dead on.
The music that I would play in more people's hearts rather than pulling full of aggression.
Hi, I'm Kwame.
Hi, this is Sarah. We are the Influence.
We try and squash a lot of flavours together. I suppose that's why we've ended up being this high-profile, low-brow band. We've just come to be pretty well-known. Michael Jackson, obviously asking us to support him around England was one big, big thing. Jacko, yes, Mr. Mike, had listened to the album. And also, he's a buyer of a magazine called Blues and Soul. And we were on the front cover of that when the album first came out. We didn't have time to meet him.
Busy schedule of a supermodel and all that, you know.
No time. Mick Jagger asking us to produce his single. Another amazing thing. He said, come, you know, I really want you to do something. We were a bit cheeky in that we'd replied by saying, you know, you're going to have to come in and re-vocal everything. So that's how we got to meet him. He came in and did his vocals, and then we had, you know, a long chat and a good laugh in the studio.
It used to be kind of frustrating when you see people doing well and your sales are not as big as your expectations and stuff. Then after a while, I just kind of figured, well, it's just not our time. You know what I mean? There's nothing you can do. You just have to kind of push on and make the music that you love and make the music that comes from you, and that's all you can do.
I don't know. I mean, it's at least we're credible, hey? Yeah. I hate to be naff, eh?
Nobody wants to be naff.
Adamski, I think. Well, I had a band last year called Jet Slags. We did one record, but we didn't make much of an effort to like put it out or anything. And just been kind of looking after my kid. She's two, her name's Bluebell. And she's just been travelling around the world with me this year. Wouldn't mind getting her home. If I do get somewhere, I don't have to move in. All I need to get is bed. I just stay at friends until they get pissed off and then go and stay with other friends. My friend's a man called Adam, they set up a label and they licensed his soul track, Dying Mathis, and I did a mix of that for them in return for them looking after my dog. The dogs are getting pissed off with me for like just like leaving her, but I haven't really got any choice.
My three favourite tracks from this week's mix are Eon, World Beyond, 4D, Hidden, and Nico, Frontiers. And you can hear them all if you phone our chart line. You can catch me playing live in the mix at Norwich every Wednesday night at the SW1 Club, or from September the 3rd at Deep Space in Palax.
Ecstasy is a very interesting drug. It's got an amphetamine-like effect, which makes people feel high and keen to keep going. It is the ideal dance drug, because the more you're doing, the more you're experiencing at the same time, the more the drug seems to be worth taking.
My name is Diaz, and I'm just about to reveal my personality in an interview coming up.